Introducing the all-new text-to-vector graphic feature in Adobe Illustrator. In a new empty document, you won't initially find text-to-vector graphic in the contextual taskbar. Instead, you can access it from the Properties panel or the text-to-vector graphic panel. After using this feature once, it will become available in the contextual taskbar. Let's dive right in. To access text-to-vector graphic, simply look for it in the contextual bar, the Properties panel, or under the Window menu. By default, the output style will match the style of the active artboard. To change this setting, toggle off the Match Active Artboard Style. Also, you can use the Style Picker to choose a style from an existing vector or image. Later, you can fine-tune your output's level of detail from the settings. Now, let's generate a scene. Describe your vision and hit the Generate button. First-time users, make sure to agree to the user guidelines. Stay connected to the internet to avoid errors. Once connected, click Generate, and you'll receive three variations. The first one is added to your artboard. In the contextual taskbar, use arrows to preview and select the one that suits your artwork best. Your generated vector graphic is neatly organized and grouped for easy editing. Refine your selection with a gradient tool or adjust the colors to your liking. Need to add a subject to your artwork? Draw a rectangle placeholder, then type in a description of the desired output in the prompt field and click Generate. You can customize the color, shape, size, etc. as desired. For instance, let's enlarge those goat horns. You can also create icons effortlessly using this feature. It's versatile and adapts to your design needs. Finally, let's explore text to pattern. Type in a description of the desired output in the prompt field and click Generate. Ensure your instructions are accurate. Any spelling mistakes could lead to errors. I've already created a path using the pen tool, meticulously outlining the sofa seating cushion. Now, let's add a pattern from the generated variations. To enhance the outcome further, let's play with blend modes. Go to the Transparency panel. Here, add a blend mode. For instance, I chose Multiply. Notice how it beautifully blends all the textures and shadows, just like it would in real life. These options allow you to incorporate details from the raster image, such as lighting effects, curves, and distortions. Explore the presets and color controls to refine and limit your output's colors. You can even incorporate your brand's color palette using this. With endless possibilities and use cases, we can't wait to see what you create. Try it out and share your thoughts in the comments below.